In this worksheet, we're going to practice drawing the SN1 reaction. First thing that we need to do is analyze our reactant, our substrate, and make sure that the carbon holding the leaving group is either secondary or tertiary. SN1 does not work if we are dealing with a methyl or a primary substrate. So that just simply means that the carbon holding the leaving group has to be bonded to at least two other carbon atoms. The next thing we should do is analyze our leaving group. If our leaving group is OH or NH2, that's a bad leaving group. And in order to make the reaction work, we're going to need to protonate that leaving group with an acid. So here I'm showing HCl being used to protonate or put an extra hydrogen on the oxygen atom, which turns it into a good leaving group. If this is NH2, we would be protonating the nitrogen, turning it into NH3 with a positive charge. Once our leaving group is satisfactory, and this is a step that we will not always need to do. Once the leaving group is satisfactory, then the leaving group will leave, and this will result in the formation of a carbocation. Once the carbocation has been formed, we're going to analyze that carbocation and see if we can do some sort of rearrangement to make it more stable. That's not always going to be possible. Sometimes the carbocation that's formed is going to be the most stable carbocation, in which case you won't do a rearrangement, but whenever rearrangement would result in a more stable carbocation, you need to do it. Once you have got the molecule in the most stable carbocation, the next thing that will happen is your nucleophile will attack that carbocation to finish the substitution reaction, like that. And if the nucleophile is charge neutral, meaning the thing that we're doing the attacking with, if that thing does not have a charge on it, the product of the reaction, which I'm showing right here, is going to be positively charged. In order to fix that, you will need to do a deprotonation, which just simply involves taking a second version of that nucleophile and abstracting one of the hydrogen atoms, one of the extra hydrogen atoms, which will leave us with a neutral product. This is also a step that you won't always need to do. Let's practice some of these reactions. So for the first reaction, first thing that we do is find the carbon that's holding our leaving group, and we need to analyze that carbon and make sure that it's either a secondary or tertiary. This carbon atom is bonded to two more carbon atoms, which makes it secondary, which means that it is capable of doing the SN1 reaction. The next thing that we're going to do is analyze our leaving group. This is one of our bad leaving groups, but we've got this HCl here to help us turn this into a good leaving group. So we're going to protonate the nitrogen using the hydrogen of the HCl. This is going to turn it into NH3+, which is a good leaving group. The next thing that happens is that leaving group just spontaneously leaves all by itself. That carbon-nitrogen bond breaks, and we have a carbocation. Once that carbocation has been formed, then we're going to rearrange it. In this case, we're going to do a rearrangement to make a tertiary carbocation. We've already spent a lot of time talking about carbocation rearrangements, so hopefully that's, you know, process that doesn't need a lot of explanation. And then this tells us that for the first reaction, Cl- is our nucleophile. So the Cl-, that's going to be the Cl- that was left over after the protonation in the first step. Cl- is going to come in and attack. And here is our product. And we're going to practice again. Here's another one. First thing that we want to do is find the carbon holding the leaving group. Make sure that that carbon is bonded to at least two additional carbons. So this is bonded to three, which makes it a tertiary carbon. Since it's a tertiary carbon, that means that this reaction or this molecule is capable of doing the SN1 reaction. The leaving group is going to leave. Leaves us with a carbocation. Have a look at that carbocation. This carbocation is a tertiary carbocation, which means it is as stable as it could possibly be. It can't get any better than that. So we are going to just proceed with the reaction. The lone pair of electrons on the oxygen are going to come in and attack that positively charged carbon. Now, this is a neutral nucleophile, so have a look at what happens here. The oxygen is going to form the bond, so the lone pair of electrons on the oxygen atom is going to form that bond to the carbon, so there's that oxygen. and there's a hydrogen and a CH3 group on that oxygen, and that oxygen atom has a positive formal charge because it has three bonds and one lone pair. And so because our nucleophile was charged neutral, we're going to need to do a deprotonation. What would we use to do the deprotonation? You know, we don't super know in chemistry. I like to use a second nucleophile. Sometimes people will use the leaving group to do the deprotonation. I'm going to use a second nucleophile for the deprotonation. Any lone pair of electrons that you have, come in and grab that hydrogen atom and get rid of it. It's always going to be the hydrogen atom. You're deprotonating, meaning you're removing the hydrogen atom. So there's that product. And then last but not least, here's our last one. Here's our carbon atom with the leaving group. We want to make sure that that carbon atom has at least two more carbons. It does. We're going to break that carbon-chlorine bond and form a carbocation. That is also a tertiary carbocation, which means it's not going to rearrange. This nucleophile is pretty straightforward. So it's going to attack our carbon, and there is our product.